Hi guys, welcome to my channel. In this video, I want to show you how I made possibly the cheapest smart radiator valves. I've been using this setup in my home for a few weeks, and so far I'm really satisfied with it. And since I couldn't find anything like this, I decided to make a quick video showing what you need to build this setup for yourself. It's actually really simple. So, I was thinking about smart heating in my home ever since I started my smart home journey a few years ago, but I couldn't reason such an investment because smart radiator valves are quite expensive. We're talking like 50 euros a piece plus a hub, so for 4 radiators in my apartment it would cost me approximately 250 euros, which is quite a big investment considering that it might need many years to pay off, if at all. And additionally, I would need to sacrifice my comfort in winter to save on heating. So I decided it's most likely not worth it and postponed it the next winter. But recently, because of the energy crisis, my heating costs have tripled. So I decided I want to give this project another go. Since I already had a home assistant and temperature sensors in my smart home setup, I needed only a super simple solution that could just enable or disable my radiators from Home Assistant. At first, I wanted to find a servo motor that I could just fit on my radiators, but unfortunately, I could not find anything. Only a few projects that required a 3D printer, which looked like an unreliable solution and too much DIY for me. Plus, I didn't want to deal with 3D printing, so this was not an option for me. And eventually I found these actuator valves on AliExpress for 5 euros. They are powered by 230 volts. And right away I came up with an idea how I can put this all together. So I can briefly show you comparison to the regular thermostatic valves. This actuator is a lot smaller, but the connection is exactly the same. It's the same size, this M30, so when you're ordering, make sure it's really the same as your existing one, so it fits. And the idea is exactly the same. This thing here is being pushed out to disable or enable your radiators. So installation is really simple. You just remove this one, replace it with this one actuator, and plug this thing in the power socket. And yeah, that's basically it. So for this setup you will also need a power cable that is long enough to reach a closest power socket, a smart power switch. This one right here is Sonoff Mini R2. I really like this one because it's inexpensive. It's compact and it also has those screw terminals, so you can easily connect all the cables without needing to solder anything, and you're good to go. And of course also a temperature sensor. This one right here is ME temperature and humidity monitor too. I also really like this one because it's inexpensive as well. You can very easily flash a custom firmware on it and connect it to Home Assistant, and even configure a custom settings how often it reports data to your Home Assistant. And for me, it's been working very well. It's very stable, and yeah, I like it. But in case you already have some kind of other temperature monitors or power sockets like this one, you could just as well use those, as long as you can control them from Home Assistant. And also the Home Assistant itself, for me, I have it running on Raspberry Pi 3 and it's been working very good as well. Additionally, you could extend this setup with the window sensors, which I have done in my living room. So for example, when you open the windows, there is automation that will disable the heating automatically, so you can hopefully save some more energy when your windows are open. And yeah, now I can show you how it actually works. I will connect it to power and open up Home Assistant. In the Home Assistant, you can easily set up this integration. It's a thermostat where it basically reports the data from the thermometer and you can set the desired temperature. Right now it's set to 24 degrees and the heating is on, so this power switch is on. But in case we want to lower the temperature to, example, 16 degrees, we can instantly hear that this switch turns off and also see the status changes. And yeah, that's basically just how it works. It checks the current temperature, and depending on that, it enables or disables this power switch. And you could also override these settings right here. Additionally, I have a scheduler set up, so in the evening it reduces the temperature to 18 degrees, so it's not heating during the night, and in the morning it sets back the desired temperature. And we can see in the history how it's been working. For example, yesterday, as we can see during the night, the temperature was dropping, then it set its target temperature to 21.5, and here we see that it's heating. And yeah, that's basically it. We can also see a weekly view, and yeah, half of the time the power is it's off heating during the night, and when it's it reaches the target temperature, it automatically turns off, so it's not heating when it's not necessary. And yeah, that's about it. Now I will show you how to replace your existing valves with the smart actuator valves. You will need a tool something like this, and just unscrew the your existing valve. So yeah, this is how it looks. Here you can see that there is this little pin thing, and it yeah, just like that. And in order to remove the, just put it up and remove it. Easy. Then you need to feed this thing through here. Hopefully this one can go through. Just put the cable. Yeah, that's it. Now you just need to connect this cable to your power socket.